our books of being. Like many, I feel as if I have completed a whole book of being, filled with chapters of change and revelation, of self-knowledge and the joyous journey of discovery of the various harmonics in life, the harmonics of self-refinement, and the gifts this brings as we all are then magnetized through so many realms and dimensions in the matrix of creation. The harmonics of family and community life, the harmonics of being one people on one planet, the harmonics of true tantra or oneness in relationship to a lover, and the joy that this brings as our romantic relationship goes into higher and purer levels of expression, plus all the other streams of energy we can develop and play in. The reason I say that my book of being is complete is that making the experiential shift to unity consciousness creates a whole new book, for it is a completely different paradigm to all that we have known on Earth before. Perhaps our books of being are like a series, each one complete in themselves, and each one a chapter of a much greater book again, a book that appears to have no beginning and no end. The book of being in unity consciousness obviously runs by the same universal rules and laws as all books. However, the mindset within it is very different to what we have experienced on Earth before, as we played our games of judgment and separation. One of the dominant frequencies in the book of being in unity consciousness is allowance, total acceptance of the isness and perfection of everything, and the allowance for all to unfold around us as it needs to, free from any judgment of right or wrong. This was a big lesson for me this tour time, as I watched what unfolded in Colombia and recognized how I wished that all who were there could match the frequency of the attending tribes, so that their pure wisdom could flow as freely as it has when I have been with the Mamos of Colombia in the past. Was I in true unity consciousness then? No, because I was assessing the situation, hoping people could settle quickly into the pure streams already there, rather than allowing and accepting what was needing to be expressed. With or without my concern and focus in the group energy pool, over the coming days, the attending group did blend and find its peace with all that was there, as it always does and always will when people gather with pure-hearted intention, or learning and expanding in awareness as we do. By the time I got to India nearly 2 months later, I had changed sufficiently and been challenged sufficiently to shift, I hope permanently, into the unity consciousness field. In India, I continued to understand and feel another level of the attributes of essence, an attribute we could call the tribe of the I Am. We all know that we have a common baseline frequency upon which our own unique experiences weave or leave an imprint. We call this baseline frequency our essence, the I Am that I Am, pure energy that supports all of creation. Perhaps we understand that, yes, we are all cells in a divine body of being, part of one vibrating mass of beingness, an idea that we experience when we meditate and feel our essence deep within, with its pulse of love and wisdom. Translating this to an actively real, non-judgmental state of allowance takes the idea into an experience of truth and true unity consciousness. For me, this translation happened over a few days in India, triggered by an aha moment change of mindset. At the Global Congress of Spiritual Scientists, Patraji had been talking to the group in his morning satsang after meditation about how we are all just like fingernails on the hand of a giant, how when we are unaware of who we truly are, when we identify too much with our physical structure, we tend to think that the totality of our being is just our existence as the fingernail. Yet when we meditate and feel our essence and identify with our essence instead, our consciousness expands and we see that we are not just the fingernail, but we are the finger, the hand, and the whole body. While his satsang was different to this, and his focal point was more about the intelligence of the whole beingness being far greater than that of the fingernail, it was an analogy that sat well with the group and led to many discussions. For me, I realized that this divine beingness, this essence that supports us all, has elected to have many unique expressions within the flow of creation. The experience of being the fingernail on the middle finger is different to being the fingernail on the little finger. Both are different again to the experience of being the bone or the knuckle of a finger. I began to see the people I love also as little fingernails who need to have their own unique experience as a member of the I Am tribe, where the idea of tribe represents all the unique expressions of the vast I Am consciousness that is being taken. In this understanding, it is so obvious that firstly, every life form is just a slightly different expression of our own I Am, and each one has its own unique formula of experience that is perfect for it. Hence, there is no need to judge, and every requirement for us just to accept. For example, if someone that we care about is choosing a potentially short life, peppered with experiences of living in an alcoholic haze, then it is wonderful that they, as an expression of our I Am essence, can have this experience for us. They would not have set this experience up for themselves if it did not have value for them on some level, and they cannot come out of this experience until they are ready and their learning is done. Separation consciousness is maintained when we judge ourselves or each other as not being in the perfect rhythm that we believe we or others should be in. Yet who is in control anyway? Surely our I Am essence, in all its wisdom, knows what sort of experience we need to have in all realms. And because our essence is the very baseline frequency within creation, then everything expressed from this essence is an aspect of us as the I Am tribe. Everything is just us having a unique experience that adds to the whole, so all is perfect. Somehow in India I got this, really got it, and so I let go. Within an instant, so much in my life changed, and it really felt as if my whole book of being, of separatist thinking within the dual-natured worlds, was complete. And with this pure acceptance, everything around me has been set free. In this expanded state of awareness, I can feel how I exist as this endless beingness, a pure essence that permeates everything, and how just a drop of this essence is within a physical structure that I call my life on earth today. The beauty of our essence, I Am awareness, is that we can travel unhindered through the matrix of creation, moving faster than the speed of light, to focus on any aspect of this divine beingness that calls us. There is no limit and no restriction, except if we believe there is. In India, I met Dolores Cannon and heard of her research with hypnotherapy to access this infinite wisdom of essence consciousness. And coming home finally to Australia, I downloaded her three books of the Convoluted Universe series, although book four is soon to be available as well. Taking time each day to read all that was covered in book one felt as if again the book of my being to this point has been reaffirmed, made stronger somehow, as all that I read correlated perfectly with my own private journey of understanding in the matrix. We all have so many amazing experiences in our dream life, in meditations, sometimes from using sacred power plants or shamanic tools, and just by going through the myriad of challenges we have faced, by identifying too much with our physical being structure and not enough with our essence, the energy that keeps a body alive. For so long we have accepted so many limited realities that come with duality consciousness, until we could learn what was needed and expand out from this into a more unified field. Here we truly are happy for all the experiences each life form has chosen to have, for we know that each adds unique flavors to the whole that we can all experience and gain benefit from as we open to the oneness flow. Through this letting go of judgment of others also comes the letting go of judgment of ourselves, for we realize that while a drop of our essence is having a human experience right here, right now, this same essence self, as the I am that I am, is having a multitude, an almost infinite number of simultaneous experiences through the matrix. Being Elohim, being angelics, being ascended ones, being extraterrestrials in all their flavors, being elements and elementals, being universes and cosmic plasma flows. The list is as endless as our imagination, and yes, we are doing it all simultaneously here now. And in this light, we can relax and just enjoy this human expression for all that being human contains, loving the fact that we have bodies, loving the fact that we have our seven senses with which to enjoy all realms, including this dense physical plane on earth. With the gift of hearing, we can choose to listen to music that really feeds our heart, and so right now I am loving the album called Rakala, which is being sung by a blind Aboriginal man called Jeffrey Jurimal Yunupingu, whose voice radiates out with a pure heart essence that somehow seems to nourish my soul. Right here, right now, my eyes can see the beauty of the bush birds feeding on wild bird seed on my veranda just feet away as I take time in silence each day. Right here, right now, I can breathe deep and slow to match the rhythm of my I am essence as it breathes through me without effort. In its rhythm, there is only peace to be found and deep contentment. Right here, right now, I can close my eyes and let my awareness expand out away from my physical form to flow like cosmic plasma, fluid and free, going anywhere through any dimension that my frequency can match to and allow me to be magnetized into. Right here, right now, I can feel appreciation for every life form in our vast I am tribe, acknowledging and treasuring the experience that each life form is gathering back into the whole. To be this truth, to feel it, and not just know of it, this too brings so much freedom as we feel and sense and know the perfection of it all. Allowance, acceptance, and freedom are a trinity of expression in a unified world which cannot become unified until we recognize the I am that lives in us all, and in this essence choose to be here now. So it is, and so it always has been. This is Jasmuheen for the Embassy of Peace Heart Talk.